Hey Pisces, welcome back to Distilled Tarot. My name's Shannon. I'll be guiding you through today's reading. This is going to be our daily reading for Sunday, February 14th. Let's see what's going on with Pisces. The heart of your reading, we have the Nine of Wands reversed. I'm getting the energy of like being released early on good behavior. Like you get out of an obligation because you've done such a good job and you've devoted yourself to it. We might actually be talking about an early release from a prison sentence. Show me. I don't know if people who are incarcerated are able to watch YouTube, but I know that there are cross-watchers, so I could be connecting with that energy, certainly. The challenge is the Knight of Pentacles. Incremental steps toward a long-term objective. It's the energy of, well, I've been working toward this thing for so long and it's unexpected now. Yeah, I don't feel like this is quitting or shirking responsibilities. I actually feel like someone is being released from an obligation unexpectedly and early. It comes as a big relief, Ten of Swords reversed at the bottom of the deck. But the challenge is like, oh, well, I've been like, this is my routine. My routine is like my whole kind of life is incorporated in this thing that I've been doing. Now that I'm not doing it anymore, what am I going to do? What is Pisces focused on? Knight of Wands in reverse. What are all the things that I've wanted to do all this time that I haven't been able to do? Making up for lost time. Show me the energy of the recent past. Ten of Wands in reverse, releasing the burden. Okay, I understand why it's in this order. Okay. It took me a second to put the pieces together. To use the prison analogy. When the decision was made for early release, that represented the alleviation of the sentence, the totality of the obligation, the requirement was removed. So it was the burden, it was an obligation, and then it was removed. And then came the reaction to that. Oh, I thought I wasn't going to be done with this for a while. That's why we're moving from the 10 to the 9, and it's actually a progression into the future. Sorry, I'm super analytical about those sorts of things, and it usually leads me to an interesting interpretation. Let's see the energy of the environment. Six of Pentacles, Queen of Swords in reverse. I'm not sure what I have to offer now. I don't know how my needs will be met. It's like, where do I fit into the environment in terms of supply and demand? What do I need now for my environment? How will I have my needs met? And What do I have to contribute? What do people need from me? I'm getting a strong sense of like, I've been doing this one thing for a while, and if that routine is gone, like, okay, well, how can I be productive now? How can I contribute? What do people even need? If not this thing that I am not going to be doing anymore. It's a recognition from spirit that you're looking at the situation, you're not seeing it yet, and they recognize that. They feel like, okay, you're okay where you're at right now. It's not how to say this? The sense that they're giving me is like, you're right on track. Looking at this and wondering and trying to make sense of it is exactly where you're meant to be at this time. In the near future, we have the Seven of Pentacles. It's a nice progression again from the six to the seven now. Assessing what is needed from you and what you can contribute and what you need from your environment to, okay, I know what I'm going to contribute toward, and I'm going to really invest myself in it. I'm going to contribute to it. I'm going to stick around and make sure that the contribution is cultivated into a positive result. It's like finding something new to work on that will produce a result. It's a strong sense of feeling productive. Your surprise energy is that emotional confusion is going to clear up. Seven of Cups reversed. You'll get clarity over, well, I could move in any direction now. What do I possibly want? You'll figure out where your heart is leading you. And that will be your indicator of what will be a rewarding path for you. What you'll enjoy doing. Show me hopes and fears for Pisces. Three of Wands. I hope that when I make my request to the universe, that they hear me. I hope that when I put my faith in something, that faith will be repaid with a result. Show me the end result for Pisces. What is the result? What is the likely result? Page of Wands reversed. Well, that's finding out what you don't want to do, what doesn't hold your interest. Tell me more about the Page of Wands, please. What is Pisces not wanting? Hierophant in reverse. Okay. Hierophant stands for institutions, and since prison came up in the interpretation, it could be referencing back to the wands of the past. The sentence. If someone's released early from prison and is having trouble adjusting to the new circumstances, there could be a not so secret desire to go back to familiar territory. If that's the case, then I can see this interpretation meaning losing the desire to go back. Losing the desire for the wand's energy, for the burden that was being carried, for the incarceration, the setting that that provided, the structure, the foundation that it was the walls of your life, literally. It was the not only the actual physical walls, but it provided a routine. I know what I do. I know what my function is. And it's very, I guess, can't, well, I don't want to read too much into it because I don't want to oversimplify it. I know that it's a very complex experience, just like anyone's life. One aspect that I'm theorizing here is that it can provide a sense of stability in knowing exactly what's to be done day to day to day. And if that's the case, I can see this meaning losing the desire for the stability that that provided and recognizing that, like the limiting energy that was represented by that Hierophant, by that institution. This can also be religious beliefs that start to feel oppressive. Like unraveling yourself from the beliefs instilled from a religion. Your advice? Ten of Cups in reverse. Don't settle for anything less than ideal emotional fulfillment. If you put yourself in a box, then, you know, the box can only provide so much, but it'll limit you from your full measure of happiness. You deserve to be completely happy, not just partially happy. The routine can't take the place of emotional fulfillment. And what Spirit wants for you is to open the door to what's truly going to make you happy, like completely, thoroughly living a life filled with joy. Pisces, I hope that helped. Enjoy the rest of your day, and I will see you back tomorrow.